Hey guys, this week's members blog is why one-arm drills are robbing you of valuable practice time and holding you back from achieving your best sequence. It's inevitable this time of year when we start seeing even high-level players coming back in to start training again as we get closer to Thanksgiving, that as I wander around facilities and see guys in cages, here comes the one-arm drills. Guys working on path, trying to isolate one hand, using the backhand, working on staying inside the ball and creating path, basically with a pushing motion. So the one-arm drills, the reason why they're holding you back from achieving better bat speed, good path, or your best swing sequence is because there is no resistance that's on the upper body, which is needed with two hands. So when we're using the one-arm drill, we're giving up the resistance of the upper body against the turn or fire of the rear leg. That's the sequence that inevitably slots the rear elbow very tight to the body, gets you inside the ball, and allows you to get that good extension. So that is the path desired, and the reason people that do one-arm drills tend to go to them, trying to get inside the ball and through their extension point. So when we're doing one-arm drills, it's crazy to think that one arm plays any more importance or dominance of the other hand, and isolating and working on one hand at a time is achieving something greater in the swing. What one-arm drills allow you to do is get really good at hitting with one arm. Not sure that plays any relevance when getting in a batter's box and trying to become a better hitter. When I'm working the bottom hand, essentially is what I'm doing is working a pushing motion in a linear fashion. I'm sliding my hand and barrel inside my face, inside my chest line, in a direct line to contact, something that doesn't happen during the swing. In fact, that pushing motion is exactly what we're trying to stay away from, because with resistance, the first action of the barrel is actually going to go rearward. To think that the top hand is a whipping action with one hand just isn't so, because the whip that we create with the bat comes from the torque and sequencing needed with two hands, resisting on the handle of the bat into my scapload upper body load position while the lower body is beginning to fire. That tension and resistance is what increases torque and creates your best path. So using that in the upper body and just using one hand, even my top hand, it's difficult if not impossible to hold resistance enough to achieve that same torque and the slotting action created by it. So guys, instead of trying to warm up, create path, or think that one hand isolation drills are going to make you any better or more efficient in path and bat speed, stop wasting your valuable practice time and start working or continue working on drills that affect and address the sequence. That's going to give you your best bat speed and the desired path you're looking for.